the content in this video will be showed. How to identify and connect a single-phase AC motor with multi-wires and a capacitor attached? Step by step. As example here, this is a fan motor, single-phase AC 230 volt. It has fixed with multi-wires and a value of 2 μF capacitor to be connected. In order to eliminate any of these wires connected to motor's body, in other words, any earth wire, by using a multimeter's ohm position to measure these wires, if their ohm value is zero between any wire and motor's body, the multimeter has been checked, and it is okay. All of wires have been checked, and no one is for the earth wire. Incidentally, although this motor has no earth wire, it can be added the one like here, which this end of earth wire screwed to motor's body. And the other end of wire to be connected to the larger pin of power plug. There is no earth wire among of those as we've known, but they have to be found out which one to which, for the sake of a capacitor and power connections. I'll draw a diagram for a capacitor and motor's internal winding coils connection. The motor's internal has two winding coils which connected in series. These are the ends of coils with two wires go out. That is two coils joint. A capacitor must be connected to the wires come out from the coil ends. This is coil 1 and that is coil 2. A capacitor is here. There are six wires come out from inside the motor, so some wires must come out coil 1 along here as well. Let's find and identify them out. Here we go. A table has been organized to measure ohm value for any possible two wires between them. Column on the left is for two wires name and color, such as white and gray, white and red, white and brown, etc. All wire have been included. A multimeter's ohm position is used for measuring their value. Starting from top of table, white and gray. Zero ohm. Then filling this value into next blank cell, in middle column. White and red. ohms. Then filling this value into next blank cell. white and brown. (294 ohms). Then filling this value into next blank cell. White and black. (338 ohms). Then filling this value into next blank cell. White and green. (580 ohms). Then filling this value into next blank cell. As above have been done, continuing to measure and fill all values into the rest blank cells. It can be seen from this diagram. Along coil 1 and coil 2 are filled with all values from the cells. A capacitor must be connected to the ends of coil 1 and coil 2, which their resistance value is the largest figure among those in the table. By looking into this table, 580 is the highest number. Corresponding wires are white and green. So white can be written here. And green written there. A capacitor is connected to white and green wires. Hang on a second. From top of the table, we can see those of white and gray's ohm value is zero, which means white and gray wires are exchangeable. To avoid confused, a short yellow wire is connected between white and gray wires. Now a value of 580 ohms, which gray and green wires can be used, instead of white and green wires as a moment ago indicated. Connecting a capacitor's wire of the one end to gray wire. Connecting that capacitor's wire of the other end to green wire. That's it. Pushing a connected capacitor and yellow wire, which connected white and gray wires away. The rest of three wires, black, brown, and red wires to be identified. Gray can be marked here, of course. What's color of the wire which comes from coil's joint has to be found out. This wire is from coil's joint, which can also say from the end of coil 1. By looking into table's top 4 cells, the highest value is 338 ohms, which corresponded to white and black. So the wire from coil joint must be the black one. White or gray, green, and black. These three wires are the basic principle of single-phase AC motors operation. Two of these wires are N for neutral, L for live from the live power, which has not switched on yet. They must be connected the way like this. Or the way like that, which the motor's turning is against the way previously. We'll connect the motor in this way in next step. Connecting neutral to motor's white wire. Connecting live to motor's black wire. All done. Switched the power on. Then the power off. The motor turned clockwise. Unplugged neutral from white wire. Then connected neutral to green wire. They are connected in this way. Switched the power on. Then the power off. The motor turned anti-clockwise. The values of 294 ohms and 216 ohms. Must be along coil 1. Which are located along here for 216 ohms. Then along there for 294 ohms. So the corresponded wire from here is the brown one. Then, the one from there must be the red wire. At this stage, conclusion can be drawn. The 216 ohm section is for red wire, high speed. The 294 ohm section is for brown wire, medium speed. The 338 ohm section is for black wire, low speed. These are the brown and red wires. Next, I am going to connect them one by one for testing run. Connected live wire from the power to the brown wire, which is medium speed. Neutral wire from the power is still connected to the white wire. Switch the power on. Then the power off. This was medium speed. Connected live to the red wire, which is high speed. The other wire unchanged. Switched the power on. Then the power off. All good. Summary. In this example, a capacitor must be connected to these two wires, which are the gray and green ones. The green, black, and white wires are the basic wires for normal operation. And they are here. Green, black, and white. So the numbers can be marked along here. Black as 1. Brown as 2. And red as 3. So, 1 as low speed, 2 as medium speed, 3 as high speed. That's it. Now you've known how to identify and connect a single-phase AC motor with multi-wires and a capacitor attached. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe. If you have enjoyed the video, your encouragement is my motivation.